appendix. In this coming few minutes, we will study about the anatomy of the appendix, then the inflammation of appendix, appendicular mass, abscess in the appendix, and three minor topics, that is mucosal formation, pseudomyxoperitony, and neoplasm in the appendix. Starting from the anatomy of the appendix, its size is about 7.5 to 10 cm normally, and the distance from the ileocecal valve is about 2 cm. And there are different types of appendix. Among them, it can be remembered as cecal. In cecal, it can be either retrocecal, subcecal, or paracecal. In ileal part, it can be preileal or postileal. And the last type is the pelvic type of appendix. And which do you think is the most common type of appendix? It is the retrocecal. Okay, and then the blood supply of the appendix, the articular supply of the appendix, is the ileocolic artery, okay, which is a branch of superior mesenteric artery. And now the next question which is usually asked is the lump or the mass that is seen in right iliac fossa. Then it can be remembered as, what are the structure present in the right iliac fossa? Okay. And the pathology that is related to that structure will be the mass. So simply the first will be our appendix. It can be appendicitis, appendicular mass, appendicular testis. Then it can be cecum. Cecum, what are the pathology? There can be tuberculosis of the cecum. There can be amebioma of the cecum. Okay. Even the typhoid can also affect cecum. Any carcinoma of the cecum. And then the ovary in the female. And there can be ovarian mass, ovarian rupture of the ectopic pregnancy in the ovary. Ectopic. Any carcinoma, and the other is the fallopian tube. And fallopian tube ka disease kya hota hai? There will be ectopic in the fallopian tube. There can be tumor of the fallopian tube, ectopic and tumor. And then even the uterus mass, as in case of pedunculated fibroid, can also be seen as a right iliac fossa mass. Uterus mein agar fibroid ho gaya. And some of the lymph node, like iliac lymph node, if it is enlarged, then it can also be seen in right iliac fossa mass. Iliac group of lymph node. And on distended testes, psoas major, these are also a rare type of diseases. On distended testes and psoas abscess. So this is the way to remember the mass that is present in the appendix. And this is all about the anatomy of the appendix. We will go to the appendicitis now. As I said earlier, that it is the inflammation and infection of the appendix, usually due to obstruction in the, suppose that this is the appendix, then when the proximal part of the appendix is disrupted and the obstructed, actually this obstruction is due to fecolith, it can be due to lymph node hyperplasia or any helminthic obstruction, or at last very rarely it can also be due to some sort of carcinoma of the cecum. Okay, so these were the cause which obstructed the lumen of the appendix, which will result in the progression of inflammation in the appendicular lumen. Okay, and then the clinical presentation, the classical presentation of the appendix, the pain starts from the para umbilical region, which is usually due to the inflammation of the visceral peritoneum, para umbilical region, and this pain usually lasts for less than 72 hours. And the feature of this pain is colicky type, and the cause of this pain was due to the visceral peritoneum ka inflammation. Then this pain usually migrate to the site of right iliac fossa, right iliac fossa pain, and the cause of this pain will be now parietal peritoneum inflammation. And this pain is usually sharp and localized type. And some of the other presentation will be anorexia, nausea and vomiting. Anorexia, nausea and vomiting. This feature can be remembered as given by the Avogadro scoring for the clinical diagnosis of the appendicitis. So this was the clinical picture, okay? And some of the other presentation or alternative presentation can also be present, that the pain can either be shifted to the upper quadrant, as in case of long appendix, it can also come to the lower quadrant, as in case of pelvic appendix. Means there were different types of appendix. If the appendix is long, then the pain may go to upper quadrant of right iliac fossa or upper right quadrant, and if it is pelvic type of appendix, then it can affect lower quadrant of lower right quadrant, okay? So you should always consider these points too. And if the inflamed appendix gets associated with, may also be associated with urinary symptoms in case of pelvic appendix. So these were the typical and atypical type of appendicular appendicitis presentation. Then the diagnosis of the appendicitis is usually via the Avogadro scoring. Avogadro scoring can be remembered as a mnemonics, that is Mantrels, Mantrel. Initially there was one more component, that is ACE, but now it is removed from the Avogadro scoring. M is the migratory pain, as we saw that the pain started from peri-umbilical region, whereas it eventually at last it goes to the right iliac fossa. And A is the anorexia, and this is nausea and vomiting. T is the tenderness in the right iliac fossa. R is the rebound tenderness. Rebound tenderness is tenderness while lifting our hand upward, not during while pressing the right iliac fossa, but while lifting our hand from the right iliac fossa, if the tenderness is present, then that is called as rebound tenderness. E is the elevated temperature, and L is the leukocytosis. Leukocytosis. And S was the shift to the left, in which the immature neutrophil amount in the peripheral smear is increased. Shift to left. And the total score, look, these two component, that is the leukocytosis and the other is the tenderness in the right iliac fossa, is composed of two scoring. If it is present, we will give two score. And the remaining all the component of the Avogadro scoring will have only one score, and the total score is about 10, among which if the score comes less than 5, then we are not sure that this is appendicitis, not sure. If the score is in between 5 to 6, it may be compatible to the appendicitis. Compatible, this is just a compatible score, and 6 to 9 there is probable appendicitis, probable. And at last, if the score is 10, more than 9, if the score is more than 9, then it is the confirmed case of appendicitis. So this was the use and implication of the Avogadro scoring. And some of the other investigation which we will send in the appendicitis will be blood. In blood, we will send LFT and amylase. Why did we send this? Because the right iliac pain can be due to liver cause, means biliary tree abnormality, or it can also be due to pancreatitis. So we need to rule out these both causes. For pancreatitis we sent amylase, and for liver function abnormalities we sent LFT. Then urine and imaging like ultrasound and CT scan should also be sent. Under imaging we will send ultrasound, which is very much sufficient for diagnosis of the appendicitis. Or at last, if it is not confirmed by the ultrasonography, then we will send the CT scan. And routine urine examination should also be performed to rule out UTI rule out karne ke liye. And in some of the cases, if even after performing these all the tests it is not sufficient, then we can also go for the laparoscopic diagnosis. So this was about the investigation which we will send for the appendicitis. Then the management of the appendicitis, usually the management can be divided into supportive or general management with the surgical appendectomy. First of all, the general management we will perform, we should give the patient, this is simply airway breathing and circulation type. For the circulation we are giving IV fluid and broad spectrum antibiotic. So this is all, but the definitive treatment for the appendicitis is the surgical management, and that is the appendectomy in this patient. The appendectomy, earlier the appendectomy was open type, but nowadays most commonly laparoscopic appendectomy is performed. And but one should know about the open as well as laparoscopic appendectomy. And if there is any abscess present in the appendix, then we should incision and drainage should be done percutaneously by the help of the ultrasonography. We will study in the abscess part. For open appendectomy, there are different types of incision which are very important and usually asked in examination. So the most common three incision usually in case of appendectomy is McBurney incision. This is the McBurney incision is the perpendicular line which is drawn in the McBurney which is drawn in the spinoumbilical line. Okay, and this is this line is usually in between the it is drawn from the umbilicus at top and towards the towards the line of the anterior superior iliac spine axis, and this is the umbilicus. And McBurney point ka matlab hua ki lateral 2/3 mein, this is the point, means divide this line into three parts, and lateral 2/3, this is the point where the McBurney point is situated, and the perpendicular line is drawn in case of the McBurney incision. The second type of incision can be Lange incision or Rutherford incision. These are the three incision usually, Rutherford Morrison incision. So these are the three important incision usually given in case of the open appendectomy, but nowadays only laparoscopic appendectomy is being performed. Some of the complication related to the appendectomy can be complication of the appendicitis can be either mass formation, which we will be discussing after this topic, appendicular mass, which is also known as periappendicular phlegm, and then there can be perforation or abscess formation, and after perforation there may be peritonitis, and mucosal and empyema can also be formed inside the appendix. And postoperatively there can be wound infection, abscess, ileus and fecal fistula can be formed. So these are some of the complications related to the appendicitis as well as the complication of the surgery. Now the mass, it is also called as periappendicular phlegm. Okay. This is the mass which is usually localized in the right iliac fossa and usually presents after the localization of the infection for about when the infection in the appendix persists for more than 3 to 5 days, then this mass is formed. And this mass, what are the component of this mass? This is also called as the mass in the right iliac fossa, in which all the components, means what are the organ which are situated in the right iliac fossa, that was the cecum, ileum, omentum of the gut, there was appendix and the parietal peritoneum. So these all the five component gets incorporated with one another and make a mass in the right iliac fossa, which is called as appendicular phlegm or the appendicular mass. Okay, mass in the right appendicular fossa. And as a result of this mass, there will be tender, smooth form localized, and they may move with respiration. Usually, the all the border have well made, well localized, and resonant on percussion. So these are some of the feature: tender, not mobile, well localized, resonant on percussion. So these are some of the feature. For investigation, we will send total count and radiography as a USC form, okay, to diagnose this mass. And then for the treatment of this mass, there is a regimen that is called as Osner-Seren regimen. Because once this mass is formed, we cannot perform appendectomy immediately after this. First of all, we need to resuscitate that person and keep under close monitoring. So we will do Osner-Seren regimen. Under this regimen, we have to resuscitate. This means we have to closely monitor the vitals. Monitor the vitals. Under vitals, the most important is the T, temperature, P, and then the blood pressure, temperature, pulse, and BP monitoring should be done, and we should look for the size of the mass. Progressive size means whether the mass is increasing. Size of mass should be under closed monitoring. Size of mass should be seen. Then some of the important medical supportive treatment will be like antibiotic, IV fluid. We are just supporting the all the supportive measure is given to this patient for so that he can relieve the from the feature of the appendicular mass. Then we will give analgesic. As we studied about the clinical presentation, so we are giving supportive treatment, and nasogastric aspiration is also done. And after this regimen, means normally the person comes into reliefs from all these feature, all the clinical presentation, usually in 2 to 3 days. And once this patient comes are stabilized, we send them back to home and call after 6 weeks. Send back to home. And then after 6 weeks, they are called for appendectomy. That is called as interval appendectomy. So we performed interval appendectomy in case of appendicular mass. So this is the phlegm, peri-appendicular phlegm and Osner-Seren regimen, which is done in case of this for interval appendectomy. After monitoring the vitals and after looking for the progression of the size of the mass, we manage this patient with antibiotic fluid, analgesic and nasogastric aspiration, and usually they recover in 2 to 3 days. And if there is no recovery, if the pulse rate is rising, if the abdominal pain is increasing and the size of the mass is also increasing, then immediately we should stop the Osner regimen and immediately go for the appendectomy. Okay, so this is the indication of stopping the conservative management by Osner-Seren regimen. Okay, and now the abscess inside the appendix or appendicular abscess. What could be the reason for the abscess formation? Usually the abscess is formed when there is obstruction in the appendicular proximal part of the appendix, and post to the infection inside the appendix, there will be abscess. Okay, so initially there was obstruction in the proximal lumen, then later on the bacteria and the infection came inside the lumen and started abscess formation. Usually the abscess formation is seen in case of retrocecal type of appendicitis, and USG is very much sufficient to diagnose the abscess formation in the appendix. And usually the clinical presentation will be very severe type, means all the appendicitis feature along with the very high grade fever. Then there will be toxic, tender, smooth swelling in the right iliac fossa. Right iliac fossa mein mass can be very toxic, tender and soft type of mass, and means all the feature of the appendicitis in a severe form. Okay, and usually the patient who have undergone the formation of the abscess, they are first of all managed with medical treatment like antibiotic, as we performed in Osner-Seren regimen. First of all, antibiotic is given, and under general anesthesia ka madad se, general anesthesia, we will go for the drainage of the abscess. Incision and drainage is performed for the abscess, and usually this abscess is sent for culture sensitivity, and accordingly we should subscribe from the appropriate type of antibiotic. Once the drainage is drain is placed through the separate incision, and after the abscess have subsided, after 3 months we will call this patient for interval appendectomy, and then appendectomy will be performed. So this is all about the abscess formation. There are three minor topics, that is mucosal formation. It is simply the non-sterile type of fluid present in the appendix, that will be mucus filled. Suppose that mucosal, this is mucosal. Then for mucosal, it is the sterile fluid present in the appendix. Means what happened? Initially the lumen was closed, as a result of which there is formation of fluid. It may be neoplastic or non-neoplastic, and once this is occluded, there will be collection of a sterile mucus filled lumen. There will be mucus filled fluid inside the appendix, and what could be the result of this mucus? This can either undergo perforation, and the mucus may escape out. Perforation ho gaya, so it will escape out and cause peritonitis, that will be called as pseudomyxi peritoni. Pseudomyxoma peritoni. And this is not only due to the rupture of the mucosal, it can be due to the carcinoma of appendix. Some of the other cause can be due to the rupture of the ovarian cancer. Rupture of ovarian cancer. and usually it will cause peritonitis in that region. Not peritonitis. Even though this fluid is ruptured in the peritoneum, this causes painless progressive dilation of the abdomen. Their presentation is actually painless progressive dilation of the distension of the stomach. So this is the presentation of the pseudomyxi peritone. Usually surgical debulking and oophorectomy along with appendectomy means what is the cause. If it is due to the appendicular mucosal rupture, then we will go for the appendectomy. If it is due to the ovarian origin cause, then we will go for the oophorectomy. So this is the treatment for the pseudomyxi peritone. Some of the doctors are also giving chemotherapy as a cisplatin in case of the pseudomyxi peritone. Cisplatin. Then the last component is the neoplasm. Regarding neoplasm or the tumor in the appendix, there can be two types of tumor. Either it can be carcinoid tumor or it can be adenocarcinoma of the appendix. Carcinoid tumor is the argentaffin secreting argentaffin cell tumor, which is usually situated in the crypt of liver cone. It is also called as Kulczewski cells, and usually they secrete different types of peptides, serotonin and chromaffin. These are the cause, then you will go for appendectomy. And in some of the rare cases, there can be adenocarcinoma of the appendix too. So this is all about the appendix. Thank you.